Welcome back to the F1 video series. Today's video is going to be all about real life F1 visa interviews. So we're going to be discussing three such cases which are going to help you in your preparation. Keep on watching. Hi guys, my name is Shachi. I'm a travel and visa coach. On this channel, you will find tons of useful videos on the US visa process. So make sure that you check them out. Now, we are in the F1 visa series, and the first video in this series was all about the basics of F1 visa. So if you haven't watched that video yet, make sure that you check this out. Today's video, like I said, is going to be about real life F1 visa interviews. So I have three profiles for you. All the three profiles are very different from each other. They basically represent three candidates who are from different background, who had different purpose of studying in the United States. And we are going to be looking at their interview experiences. And this is definitely going to help you in your preparation. So let's get started. So let's start with the first profile. So as the first profile, I have a candidate who had completed his 10th standard, and he was a state level basketball player, and he had gotten admit from a high school in the US. So he basically wanted to go to the US, complete his high school, and this admit was on a basketball scholarship. So the purpose was essentially to complete the high school in the US and get coached or get trained to play basketball. Now, this candidate gave two F1 visa interviews. The first visa interview resulted in a rejection, and the second one resulted in him getting the visa. So we're going to analyze both of these interviews and see what exactly went wrong in the first one and how he corrected that in the second one. So when he went for the first visa interview, the questions that were asked to him were, why USA for high school? Why not complete your high school in India? By the interest in basketball? He was also asked a lot of technical questions related to basketball just to see how genuine of a player he was, and most importantly, his future plans after high school in the US. Now, the most probable reason why his visa got rejected in the first time was because when asked about his future plans, he mentioned that in the future he wanted to join professional leagues in the US and, you know, play basketball there. Now, of course, this is something which was way into the future. It would be something that would happen after he finished his high school, you know, his graduation, and then so on. But typically in a visa interview, when a visa officer is asking you about your future plan, it is, what do you plan to do once you complete the education for which you are going to the US at present? So he should have basically spoken about his future plan after completing his high school. Moreover, by talking about joining professional leagues in the US, it clearly showed that he had no intention to come back to his home country, which resulted in a visa denial. Now, when he went for the visa interview the next time, what the candidate did essentially was to show stronger ties to his home country and a much stronger intention to come back after completing his high school. So he did his research about the possible undergrad colleges in India, and when asked what he planned to do after his high school, he mentioned very specifically that he plans to join this particular undergrad college, which was known for its sports team, in particular for his basketball team, so that he could come back to India, complete his graduation, and at the same time continue to play basketball, making use of all the training and the coaching that he would have received in the US. Moreover, he also mentioned that his intention was to play the sport for India at a national level, so he would also continue to try for that. So overall, the profile of the candidate had everything in place. He had a very valid reason to go to the US. He had a clear purpose, what he wanted to do in the US. All that remained to be done was to show stronger ties to home country and intention to come back, which was corrected in the second interview, resulting in a visa approval. Moving on to the second profile. Now, second profile, we have a candidate who had completed his BTech in mechanical engineering. He had worked for 3 years in the automobile sector, and he wanted to go to the US to do a master's in mechanical engineering, and he had several admits, but the one that he preferred was from the University of Texas. Now, this candidate, when he went for the visa interview, he got the visa on the first try itself. So the first visa interview was a success and his visa was granted. The interview questions that were asked to him were, why master's after 3 years of working? Why University of Texas? Why not complete the master's from India itself? How will you fund your education and what are your plans after doing your master's? So let's look at how the candidate answered some of the interview questions and what clicked and what was the reason his visa was accepted. The first thing that worked for the candidate was that there was a very clear link between his undergraduation, his work experience, and his master's. All three were in the same line, they were in the same field, and there was a direct connect between the two. So the candidate was able to justify that having studied mechanical engineering, having worked in the automobile sector, he needed the master's degree to basically advance his career in this field, to learn more, and to be aware of what are the cutting edge technologies and cutting edge methods that are being followed in the automobile sector. Second reason that worked for him was that he was very clear about his future plan. He was very clear that after completing his master's, he wanted to come back to India and join the same company. He had already worked for 3 years at the company. He was pretty happy with his experience and his time there. And he was very clear that after finishing his master's, he wanted to come back and join the same company at a much better designation and, of course, a much better salary. And the third thing was that the funding was in place. The candidate had a loan sanctioned. He had his own savings because he had worked for 3 years as a backup. He also had some family funds. So all the funding was in place. There was enough buffer to fund the education and there were also enough backup options. Coming to the third profile. Now for the third profile, we have a candidate who is an undergrad student. So he was doing his undergraduate in biomedical sciences. And he had completed 2 years in India and he wanted to do the remaining 2 years in the US. So his college had a tie-up with a university in the US, which allowed him to pursue the last 2 years of his undergrad in the US. Now, when he went for the interview, in the first attempt, the visa got rejected. And in the first attempt, he was just asked one single question, which is, why pursue 2 years from a US university? Why not do it in India itself from your current college? Now, the probable reason why his visa got rejected in the first attempt was that the candidate was not convincing enough about why he wanted to do 2 years in the US when, you know, he had the option of continuing in the same college and finishing his undergrad in India itself. When he went for the visa interview the next time, what we essentially worked on was on refining what his plans would be in the 2 years in the US and why a US degree would make a difference as compared to studying in India. And the whole idea was to convince the visa officer that the 2 years there would not be a general degree in biomedical sciences. It would involve doing some amount of specialization. So the candidate here was essentially interested in diagnostics, and he was also interested in a particular field in diagnostics. And the 2 years in the US university allowed him to specialize in that as compared to India, where he would be doing a general degree in biomedical sciences. So he was able to convince the visa officer that studying for 2 years there would give him this advantage of specializing in diagnostics, which would help him when he came back to India. He had also done his research about the job opportunities in India and about the hospitals in India where he would get immediately employed with a specialized degree in diagnostics. So with him in the second visa interview, which resulted in an acceptance, the entire approach was to be very specific about the plans and not to be generic at all, not to say that I'm going to the US to finish 2 years in biomedical sciences, but to narrow it down to what exactly he wanted to focus on and specialize in those 2 years. So here we have discussed three different profiles. All the three candidates are from different background. They had a different purpose of studying in the US, and of course they had very different visa interview experiences. Now the main points that we discussed were of course the key reasons, highlighting, you know, their interview experience. The actual prep that went into these interviews was much more in depth. It was much more detailed. If you want to prepare for your F1 visa interview with me, you can do that as well. You can either book a consultation session with me or you can also take a mock interview. The link for all these things is in the description box below. We also have a course, the F1 prep course, and this course will essentially help you in preparing your answers for the interview and getting ready for the D-Day. So you can also check out this course in the description box below. So this was the second video in the F1 visa series. Stay tuned for the next video. Next week, we're going to be talking all about financials. So funding is a huge part of F1 visa acceptance or rejection reasons, and we're going to be talking all about it, how much funding you need, how do you need to present it, and what are the supporting documents that you need with it. So make sure that you subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss out on this video. Thank you so much for watching. Signing off for now. I'll see you in the next one.